joy that it brings to, you know, my customers. I find that really rewarding, really, really rewarding. I think when I was a teenager, we went to Paris and I looked at all the huge big barges in the Seine and thought, oh, that's really cool, I'd love to live on something like that, you know, just trying to be alternative, I suppose. And then, I don't know, it just kind of happened.
What I like is the inventive nature of wood type, you know, because any two letters, any two words can look completely different, have a completely different meaning in a sense, with the choice of type that you use. So there's endless varieties, and what you're doing is you're creating something based on words, but there's a point where you know that things are going to be right, where you feel they're right for your own purposes anyway. I think, to me, what I like about letterpress is that it's a very practical, tactile occupation. You know, there's so many elements to the setting, design, layout, press work, all that. It just it's an endless fascination. And although you get quicker and quicker over time with the process of setting, every time that you print something.
Change has been going from fast baking to slow baking, organic grains from fast processed grains. So bringing things back. So everyone wants to go back to the start. I mean, my personality, I couldn't at all. It would drive me crazy. I need to be doing something which is creative.
I did painting. As I said, I went to Mr. Israel's. Mummy did painting, and I just kind of like loved watching her paint. And I think what I always liked about painting is the substance of the paint. Just really love moving the thick, gungy oil paint around the canvas, really. And then when I went to art school, me and a friend tried to change departments, or we wanted to go down to the ceramic department and ask if we could just have a go. And they said okay, here are the wheels, here's some clay, and this is what you do, and gave a very quick demonstration and left us to